mismo club, hay que decir que el día de hoy, this time we can see the ice cream, it will be stored inside and it will be agitated by using that agitator here in the compartment. So this compartment is double jacketed and refrigerated so that the contents are remained cool. So we will be maintaining the temperature of milk in the range of near to 0 degree Celsius. So this particular end is the discharge end. So it will be used to discharge the milk as and when required by using this lever here. So here we can see that this lever has a seal pin. So this seal pin leads the valve gate. So valve gate when it gets lifted, so milk will be transferred to the discharge port here. So at this side, we can then place cup or cones into which the ice cream is required to be discharged. So that is how this mechanism works. It is very simple kind of machine. The main thing to be noticed here is that the design of machine is such that we can store the milk near to refrigerated conditions, which means near to freezing conditions, and when the milk will be discharged, it will be in a semi-solid kind of mass. So for that kind of ice cream, we maintain temperature around about -2 to -4 degrees Celsius or so. So in that particular range, we will be getting discharge from here. Now coming on to the control panel, at this control panel we can see that we are having several other controls too. So this is the milk reference, then standby, wash, auto and pump. So what these things will be indicating or what for these will be used? Milk refreshing, milk when initially filled is required to be refrigerated. So this is for the turning on of compressor of the system. So this will be having its own refrigeration unit. It will be switched on when we use this button. So it will cool the milk to the refrigeration temperature. So standby means it will be maintaining just that temperature and cooling will be in the start stop fashion. That means as and when the temperature is increasing 1 or 2 degrees, then it will switch on the compressor. When it is reaching the refrigeration condition, it will be switching off. So the machine will be just ready to be used. Wash means when the milk is empty, next knot is required to be refilled or machine is required to be cleaned, then wash cycle will be there. So in the case of wash cycle, we will be filling this compartment with the washing solution, which will be having the cleaning solution used for cleaning of this machine specifically provided by the supplier. And if we want to use sanitizer, then also this wash cycle will be. Auto will be used when the machine is required to be run in automatic fashion. That means for the required delivery of volume, we are just required to keep this valve open in this fashion, and then we can just keep the cup at the bottom and it will be continuously discharging the milk so that we can just replace one cup after another and it will be automatically filling all the cups in a continuous fashion. Pump is for agitation. So when we are required to mix the content for equal refrigeration effect or temperature equalization, then this pump will be used. So this pump will also be used in the case when milk is refrigerated or in the opposite. So this is required to be operated in both the cases and not to be used in a standby cycle. So this will be also used in the wash so that the agitator will be ready. Now these two indicators, so this is indicating milk flow and milk out. Milk flow means the milk which is present in the machine, it is at a lower level and machine is indicating that a warning signal is there, it is running out of the material. And milk out means when the milk has completely drained out of the system, then this LED or indicator will turn. Now coming to the next part, so this is the ice cream cage feeder. Here we can see, so in this part we are having this hole at this top part and it is connected with a screw conveyor. So we are having inside a screw conveyor. So that screw conveyor will be used to discharge positively the fruit and nuts, if any, to be used as a topping. So after filling the ice cream cone or the cone gate or saucer machine, we can then keep that hole at the bottom of this particular part of the machine and switch on by using this green machine. So we are having two buttons, green for the start and red for the store. So when we will be starting green button, that is through conveyor or through auger, will be running and discharging the fruit and nuts. After it has been properly topped, we can then start it. So it is also a very simple mechanical part.